everyone, and welcome to our first vlog here from beautiful South Korea. And we are at the premier theme park in all of South Korea, Everland. It literally just opened, if I turn you around here. People are streaming in as I speak, and I've got Tess here with me, naturally. Yes. She's joining for all the fun. Just look, it's feeling pretty magical here. We haven't been to a theme park in a long while, and it's looking a lot like Disney World over here. You got like a big Main Street area. You got desserts and Starbucks and facades galore. It's all pretty impressive, and we're really excited because there's so many cool things to see at this park. The most important of them being T-Express. But also a bunch of really cool rides. You've got characters, food, there's beautiful music playing. We're all just really, really excited. So number one, thanks for joining us. Number two, I hope you enjoy our trip here around Everland here in South Korea. Tess?
Let's go.
Let's go.
I don't think he's Korean.
Check it out, guys. Over here, we have Not Frozen.
We have to get it. It smells so good.
Oh. There's like Main Street. There's like Main Street USA smells going on right now. Kind of exactly trying to mimic that Main Street USA feel, which respect, you know, it is one of the best feels.
It's
instead of like Crystal Palace, there's a noodle restaurant behind me. Yeah, you got a really nice midway, super wide. I'm not saying it's like Disney quality exactly, but it ain't bad. There is a coaster going. Look right there, folks. Oh my gosh, can I flip this around fast enough? Folks, we've got a, what I believe is an arrow looper over here, going hard. So that might be our first ride of the day. An arrow looper, a coaster. It's been a long time since we've been on a coaster. So we'll see if it hits any different than it once did. I have a feeling that arrow looper might be a good way to start the day, wake us up. Tess is very self-involved right now with the snacks. Which, I guess she's hungry.
Everyone wants to know about the food, okay? It's important. There's a bite-sized churro, like a one bite-sized churro. They have chicken skewers, which is just like a chicken stick. And then they also had like a, it looks like a corn dog, but it's chicken with like fried crunchy stuff.
Taking a detour here, we've decided to go to Aesop's Village because it looks cute. Question mark? It looks like pretty kid friendly. I'm all about the kids, not in a bad way, FBI. And there's a coaster literally right here that we saw doing a little backwards, forwards action. I think it's like a family coaster. I really don't know anything about it. But if there's one thing I do know, it's a credit. And I like credits. Tess is enjoying these plants.
Those were fake trees. These are real trees.
All right, you can go to Tessa's website, fakerrealtreeseverland.net, and get a full tree report. I'm gonna come to you live here from the coaster pretty soon, but this part of the park is really pretty. This is something like Disneyland wouldn't be able to do just because it's too tiny, and it would be like herding cattle to the slaughter. So I'm enjoying this right now. It looks like there's some good theming up here. So
cute.
Let's go check it out here at Everland. Here we go on our way to ride Racing Coaster. Tess, are you excited for our first coaster of the day?
Yeah, it's been a while since I've been on a roller coaster.
I'm sure it's for kids, but it still counts. First coaster of the day. Let's get it. Okay, we just got off of racing coaster. Tess, did it race?
There was only one train, so no.
Yeah, racing kind of implies dueling in English, but maybe that's just lost in translation.
It makes it fast.
Either way, it was a good kiddie credit. Like, as far as kiddie credits go,
yeah.
I always on the channel, like, kind of poop on the Zamperla Family Gravity Coaster or the Vekoma Roller Skater. Like, that was pretty good. It was very smooth.
Oh, I bet T-Express.
It was very smooth, and there was, like, not forces, because obviously it's a kiddie coaster, but it wasn't bad. It went backwards. It didn't go forwards at any point, so it just kind of, like, they reversed the order of the train. So it's kind of, like, worse than a Family Boomerang. But either way, I still thought it was pretty enjoyable and fun and a nice, easy way to start the day. Tess is busy checking the phone, so I will show you here. Check this out, folks. We've got a beautiful, beautiful fountain. The Wisdom Fountain, as it says it is called here. Spouting some wisdom. Let's see if Tess has any wisdom for us. Tess, you have any wisdom?
For what?
For the fans.
Wisdom about theme parks?
Just in general.
Just in general? Have fun at a theme park. There's nothing wrong.
There you go, folks. Let's keep on trucking. One of the really cool things about this place is that it's not just like a terrain coaster that it has. It's a terrain park. We're like straight up on the side of a mountain here. And the whole park is uphill and downhill, which I guess stinks if you hate walking and hate your knees, but it's pretty cool to look out here and just have this giant landscape for you to explore. So big fan of that, big fan of nature. Tess, where are we going to next?
T-Express.
All right, is it time?
Like that way.
Is it time?
There it is.
I don't see it.
It's right there.
Oh, she's not wrong, folks. There she is, way off in the distance.
We gotta go over there.
All right, well, sounds like up next we are headed to T-Express for our first ever ride on it.
Oh, it's going, it's going!
It's moving, it dropped, that means it's open, it's taking riders. Let's get over there, come on. T-Express. T-Express time. It's time for T-Express. Oh my gosh, folks, we found it. Here it is. T-Express. The T stands for trunk. Get it? It's a Kodak moment. Oh, don't tell Tess. Don't tell Tess. Don't tell her. Don't tell her.
I thought it was like real cookies, but it's a ride. But I'll still go on it.
Oh, folks, look, it's not a credit. It's not a credit. Tess keeps trying to derail the T-Express train here with the devil's temptations, like bumper cars, a disco coaster. I'm saying no way, no how. Next stop, folks, I'm seeing her for the first time. T-Express. Look at her go off in the distance. That drop looks insane. T-Express has the potential to enter my top 10 in a way no coaster has in a while. So Tess, I think we gotta go this way. It's all very confusing. It's because we're like walking down a mountain.
This is huge.
We got a giant carousel over here. Pretty cool. Still making our way around. Tess, what do you think so far?
I love, this is like Disney-esque. I'm in love with this place. The theming is so cool. I feel like I'm truly in like a new land. It's like, I mean, yeah, I am in Korea, which is new, but this is like, it feels like home amusement park, you know?
It has like a very classic amusement park feel. It's got the bumper cars, the carousel, the arcade. It's got a Dippin' Dots, folks, machine? What? I don't have to talk to humans and I can still eat ice cream? this might be the greatest day of my dang life. Wow.
We're here at Sea Express. We did it. There's a 91 minute wait.
Welcome to the Tea Express queue experience, narrated by me. Here's Tess.
Hello.
It's the Tea Pose Express. Folks, don't forget, please stretch before you go on Tea Express. 98.9% of people die on Tea Express. Here we are, folks, walking up in the queue for Tea Express. I'm beyond excited. First real coaster today. Quite a hike through this queue. They get your heart going before your heart starts going. This coaster looks insane.
Before your heart stops.
The queue is, I'm like out of breath. The queue is winding around the track. It's gonna be one heck of an experience. Oh, I'm pumped. Alright guys, it's the moment we've been waiting for. We just got off Tea Express. Initial first thoughts. So first thing, yeah, that's a top tier Woody, no doubt. It's running a little slow right now, I think, and here's why. Because on the turnarounds, it felt kind of just like turnarounds instead of getting whisked about. So we'll have to see if that changes as it continues to run. That being said though, we were back row. The ejector air, as you can probably tell from my hair, is out of this world insane. Completely ejected out of your seat, and some good moments of floater going over the hills. The first drop is ridiculous, and then there's a wave turn that just like, I guess wave turn isn't the right word. It feels like a wave turn, overbank turn, whatever you want to call it. Completely threw me off my seat. Hit Tess, poor Tess. She banged her elbow a couple times, but long story short, that's a pretty dang good ride, and it just opened, so we're planning to get more. I know, I told them, my hair. We're planning to get more rides as the day goes along. Yes. So, yeah, if I have to say it, my first impressions, is that a top five Woody for me? For sure. Tess?
Oh, I don't know. What are the Woodies we've done? Lightning Rod is my number one. I've still never
She's never
it.
Been on.
Beast?
Voyage, Legend, Voyage. Raven, I mean, I don't Mystic know. Timbers.
El Toro. Oh, no. Not in my top five.
We'll see. We'll see as the day goes on. But either way, still a really, really great ride. And we're going to get more rides as the day goes along. They're using a smart reservation system, a virtual queue, so we don't even have to wait in line to get in line, which is fantastic. We're going to keep walking around and check out more of the park and bring you more here from Everland. Hey everyone, check out the Not Rainforest Cafe. It's not the Rainforest Cafe. It's Cafe Jumble Camp. Totally different. It's not the Rainforest Cafe. We got snack number two incoming. What do we got, Tess?
Super spicy 7.7 inch chicken skewer. And when I ordered it, she's like, it's very hot. And I was like, yes.
Let's get a shot here.
Oh, in the sun? Ooh.
Oh, it's looking pretty spicy.
It's an extra.
Yep. Review incoming from Tess.
No, I want an Adam review.
We've got a great shot of Tea Express across the way here, so we'll eat and watch. Hey guys, we're back after eating super spicy chicken, and it wasn't even spicy, right, Tess?
If I let my tongue touch anything in my mouth, it hurts.
It's not even. It wasn't even. Still recovering from the super spicy chicken, but it's no worries because we're headed on our next ride here, Amazon Express. What is it? I'm not sure. I hear the sounds of rushing water, so I'm gonna go ahead and guess that it's a water attraction, but other than that, it's gonna be a complete surprise. Maybe it's a river rapids. Oh, it might be a river rapids. Tess is not gonna enjoy this, but the theming's again really, really great. Hopefully I'm getting some shots of the demon here. I'm recording. Hello, camera. Demon looks really, really great. So hopefully this all goes smoothly. We don't get too ridiculously wet. We enjoy our time on the Amazon Express.
I'm not excited. I don't like water rides where everything is soaked when you get on.
It'd be like Popeye's level of soak. Okay, we just got off of our relatively dry ride on the Amazon Express. Tess, what did you think of the Amazon Express?
My butt's only a little wet, but I like it. It was a fun ride. The raft was so interesting. It's unlike any raft in any theme park I've ridden in America.
Yeah, it was super interesting. You were in like these little capsules that weren't actually connected to the rest. They were all individual. And then there was like a poncho that you put over the capsule.
Velcro
that stopped you and your stuff from getting wet. So like if you wanted to get wet, I guess that would be, I guess you could not put the poncho on, but you'd get destroyed. You'd get absolutely soaked. So that was cool. We're gonna check out other areas in this safari area and then keep walking around. So
I think that's the zoo over there.
I'll show you what we find. Tess thinks she sees a zoo. So, oh yeah, there's aminals. Let's go look at the aminals.
Animals.
Folks, it's tiny little fennec foxes.
Little
big ear,
tiny little
fennec. All right, we're going to the zoo, folks. The zoo in the forest, top of a town. I don't even know if you can see them. Let's see what other liminals they have. I like liminals. This one. It's the world's largest rodent. But actually, though. Hey Tess, have you met my friend Al?
Al who?
Alpaca. Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you Big Turtle.
Big Mama.
Smile!
Tess and I thought we were going into a tiny little zoo, tiny little side distraction. Turns out there's like a huge zoo back here with birds and tigers and seals and foxes. What else was there?
Sea Express views.
Oh, and right on time, Tess points out, there are monkeys too. Tess points out, Sea Express off in the distance. So yes, as we were saying, we thought we were going into a tiny little sideshow and it turns out there's a giant zoo back there and a pretty dang good one, I thought.
Yeah, there's a lot of cool, all the exhibits, all the animals really aren't like the non-violent animals or the birds. It's like open. You can see the animals right there, like the monkeys, the big orangutan, not orangutan, the swinging one. There's a really cool swinging monkey.
Gibbons.
Yeah.
It's like, I would say it's like halfway between Hershey Park, Zoomerica, and Animal Kingdom. And it's closer to Animal Kingdom than Zoomerica. And included with your admission, which by the way was like 38,000 won or like $34, $33. So not bad at all considering you get access to this giant zoo. And as it turns out, there's some pandas up here. I've never seen a panda in my life. So that would be a cool experience. Well, we're kind of just like completely lost, which is, I guess is a good way to explore a theme park. The fact that you can get lost, Tess says we're not lost, we're lost. The fact that you can get lost is kind of a testament to the park itself, because I find that parks that you get lost in tend to be the better ones. So Tess is going to lead the way. Here she goes. Where are we going next, Tess?
This is technically towards the pandas.
We're going towards the pandas. So let's hope this pans out.
Yeah.
Here we are popping a relatively rare credit. It's this moving walkway. Test.
There's a lot of bees here.
How's the airtime?
Waiting for the drop.
When do we get to the ride?
No, this is the ride.
This is the ride! Yippee!
So Tess was right. We did walk right by the Panda Place. However, it's reservation only right now. And we currently have another reservation for Tea Express that we don't want to lose. So long story short, we put the pandas on pause. Now we're walking through the obvious, coolest, most imperialist part of the park, because we're headed to American Adventure, which looks a lot different from other America themed. Well, maybe it's got that like Six Flags 50s feel, like the one that's in Fiesta, Texas. And we're headed this way because there is an Arrow looper. I think it's a double looper called Rolling X Train. And it's the other big roller coaster credit in this park. So Tess,
yes?
You're navigating.
Yes, well, it's right up ahead. It should be like right there up on the, it'll show me. Yeah, it's supposed to be like right here on our right.
And there it is, folks. No, it actually is like right up there. So we're gonna head and check that out. There's a couple things in this area. There's like a top spin, which look is going right now, and a couple other things. So I'm gonna get put it to the top spin. We're gonna get on the coaster, and I'll talk to you later. Bye. Folks, I found it, the coolest KFC in the whole world. A 50s diner themed KFC. And look, BTS filmed their hit single Dynamite right here. Holy crap. But yeah, if you want some chicken in 50s America, Everland is the place for you. And here it is, Rolling X Train. We found it. We found the Arrow Looper. We're gonna get in line. We're gonna get a ride. Maybe we'll get some footage, and we'll see you when we get off. Okay, we just got off Rolling X Train, the Arrow Looper, and like, no joke, talk about a coaster that's like no frills. They were like, all right, here's what you're gonna do. You're gonna go off the drop, you're gonna do two vertical loops, you're gonna do a helix, you're gonna do a double corkscrew, and that's gonna be it. And you know what? I thought it was pretty dang good. It was relatively smooth, I guess, for like a janky Arrow Looper. You definitely didn't, like, compared to corkscrew or something at Cedar Point, you definitely don't get thrown around as badly. The restraints were a lot more comfortable. And the two loops were intense, especially the second one. I was telling Tess, I'm like, I'm pretty sure that's the first ride I've like ever grayed out on, yeah. Which I guess says something for the power of a good looper. But yeah, weird. I was like, didn't expect to like it as much as I did. Not only that, I didn't expect it to be as intense as it was. So Tess, what did you think?
It was cool. Yeah, after that second loop, you said, I think I grayed out. And I was like, me too. And yeah, it was a short ride, but it was fun. Like, I would marathon that ride, no doubt.
What we're doing now is we have another reservation for Tea Express that hits in like 60 minutes, you said?
Okay.
So we're gonna get some food.
40 minutes.
40 minutes, wow. So we're gonna get some food.
A quick snack.
And then we're gonna make our way back over to Tea Express so we can get a second ride on that. And then the rest of our time is really just gonna be spent exploring. I will say, it's a really fun park to explore because there's so many hidden nooks and crannies, and it's themed.
Oh, it's so good.
Thank God for a good theme park. I would call this a proper theme park. No, it's not as intensely themed as Universal or Disney.
It's like more themed than Cedar Point.
It's definitely more themed than any of the Cedar Fair parks. And look, it's a spooky fun house.
It's open.
Do they have that at Cedar Point? Checkmate, coaster enthusiast. You just got beat up by a fun house. Yikes. We're walking towards Holland Village, which is like their European garden slash beer garden slash village area. And I will say it looks very, very pretty. It reminds me a lot of Busch Gardens in Williamsburg and its attempt to incorporate different European countries. But there's a railroad that runs through this area. And yeah, all in all, it's just really, really pretty. I'll flip you around here so you can see. But you've just got really beautifully manicured gardens. You've got this giant, like, Greek stage, and yes, that is Tea Express right behind it. And then all throughout, fountains, really nice picture opportunities, bright, colorful plants. I'm not saying it feels like Europe, but you can see what they're going for. And it's all just very, very pleasant to sit in. This is definitely a great area if you brought food in, which you can do, to have a snack and just look around, explore, watch Tea Express in the background, watch pandas on the big screen. There they go. All right, folks, I'm gonna walk you through what we got here. A little bit of a meat plate, some salad, some fries, some sausage, some sauce, some sauerkraut, some jalapeno, some Tess eating food. She got a coffee, I got a beer, we got mustard, we got more mustard.
Ooh. What more could you need?
Unlike the rest of Korea, they actually decked themselves out for Halloween here. Pretty cool to see, and some awesome views of El Toro from here. And by El Toro, I mean Tea Express. Pretty cool. We're gonna walk down here. We're ready for our second ride of the day on Tea Express. Our reservation is ready. We're gonna head over that way. And then I guess we'll stay to get some footage so we can show you guys what the ride looks like. I'm walking downstairs, looking down carefully so I don't fall on my boot. And then I don't know, we're gonna keep looking around, but Halloween decorations, Tess, what do you think?
They're so cute. They did a good job decorating.
It's just like America. Walking through the queue of Tea Express part two. Time for round two. Let's see if it's running any faster. Tess.
Yeah, what?
What do you think?
I'm excited. Again, we just ate a lot of food, so it's kind of a bad idea.
No, it's a good idea.
It's a great idea.
You haven't tested airtime until you see how successful it is at making food go from your stomach or perhaps even your lower intestine.
Will it be warmed up?
Back up, you know, so. We'll let you know what we think. Hopefully we get a back row ride again and we can see Tea Express part two for further evaluation.
Do you think it's warmed up?
I hope so. On Tea Express. We got a front row ride because there was actually a line for the back row, no surprise. And front row was open, so we figured why not give it a swirl or a spin. And here's the interesting thing. Front row was still pretty violent as far as the airtime went. I don't think it was faster, and the first drop was definitely less good than in the back, naturally. But the airtime is just so violent. Some of the hardest ejector I've ever had. And Tess, kind of funnily and I think accurately, compared it to Magnum XL 200 at Cedar Point with how aggressive the ejector is. It's really right up there with the most aggressive ejector. Each bunny hill is like just so aggressive. It makes the slow turnaround sections feel like necessary to give yourself a moment to recoup. So I think it got even stronger even though we were in the front. So really we need one more in the back later in the day to get a final evaluation on it. Is it better than El Toro? It's still a tough question. I don't know if I can answer it yet until I get a third ride, but Tess has inputs.
So my input is that there's a green grape beer, a brew, and there's also a grapefruit brew, which, I think someone no, that's a bubble tea. I don't know. I don't know what's going on, but there's some interesting brews going on, and my head hurts just a little from the rattle, like the good kind from Tea Express, so I think it's drink time or no?
Now it's not PG. Drink it. What did you want? 감사합니다. But we're walking towards the safari. We're gonna do a little bit of safari. We already have another reservation for Tea Express, so that should be pretty easy to go ahead and knock out once it's up and running again. Shout out to the foxes, as cute as ever. We're gonna do the safari. It's a bit of a long wait. Tess is behind me. We're gonna do the safari, check it out. And then once that's over, I guess we'll ride Tea Express. We're here on the safari. Safari. Look. Safari.
Did he? Safari, we're going on a safari ride.
We'll see you afterwards.
I think we can hear us now.
What? Valley, aka one of the two safaris they have here at Everland. It's literally like they paywall half the animals behind one and half the animals behind the other. So this one there was giraffes, rhinos, elephants, camel, zebras,
rhinos, cheetahs.
Cheetahs, birds. Tess, what did you think? It was very Kilimanjaro safari, wasn't it?
It was cool. I mean, I feel like because I couldn't understand the safari leader girl, it was like not as fun, but it was cool just to see how everyone's like interacting. They fed the giraffe through the like the cages of the window in the car, so it was very
It was fun saying annyeong to all the animals as we said goodbye. But yeah, it was fun. It's a good little time. We got 45 minutes till our next T-Express ride, so maybe we'll do the fun house or something.
Yeah.
I think we'll head to the fun house. You ready to get spooked?
Yes.
Let's get spooked. Let's get spooked. Let's get spooked. Yes. Push the button.
I don't
want
it.
You gotta do it.
Annyeonghaseyo, 여러분을 환영합니다.
That is terrifying, but like not as they intended it. Guys, I'm gonna keep this brief because memory is low. T-Express, round 3, back row or bust. Tess, you ready? Let's get on and kill this third ride on T-Express. God bless Korean theme parks and their technology because they had a charging station where we were able to charge our Osmo Pocket for $1.50.
We're lucky
not bad.
That it's that small to put in a charging station.
Either way, I love it. I love it. So we're back. We've got a ride on T-Express, and we haven't talked about it yet. So Tess is taking a picture of a sign that says Sherlock Holmes because she recently watched BBC Sherlock. Shout out to that show. And also the other signs. But how was our third ride on T-Express? Well, let me tell you. Third times the charm. That was a fantastic ride. We were second to last in the back. There's a really long line for the back, and like the second to last back is inches away. So it's basically the same, guys. It's basically the same. Either way, crazy ejector. The drop is probably the most insane drop. It's like Sky Rush's drop. It's literally that insane. Instantly put T-Express as my number 2 wooden coaster, but not enough to dethrone Voyage. God, Voyage is so dang good. Tess, what are your thoughts on T-Express after your third ride?
You know what? It's like, I don't think it reaches my top 5. I'm going to be serious with y'all. Like, yeah, it's a rare credit, but like you said, there are plenty of rides in America that are just as good or better.
Do you prefer El Toro to T-Express?
No.
So that's a frame of reference. And what's your number 1 again?
It's a coaster I've never been on.
There you go, folks. But either way, did you enjoy T-Express?
Absolutely.
We've got one more ride, and it might be a night-ish ride. We've got one more ride. Reservation kicking in at 6:45. We'll go to that. In the meantime, we're going to walk around. We've got our camera back so we can get more footage and explore the rest of this park. Tess and I were just talking. We were to say, if there's one park we would compare this to in America, it would probably be Dollywood.
Disney.
Tess says Disney, I say Dollywood. The Main Street area reminds me of Dollywood. We're surrounded by mountains, that reminds me of Dollywood. There's hills up and down, that reminds me of Dollywood. And the ride selection reminds me of Dollywood as well. It's not super stacked, but what they have is pretty quality. And the theming's really good as well. And they also have that 50s area that again is like very reminiscent.
With the the like German type snacks. They have like a French area. They have this huge garden place.
No, that's true. That's clearly like Epcot. And they also have like the Animal Kingdom.
Yeah.
It's kind of like Busch Gardens Williamsburg in that respect. I don't know. It's kind of a mishmash. It's like a little bit Animal Kingdom, a little bit Magic Kingdom.
Disney.
A little bit Hollywood. Tessa is Disney. Either way, we're really enjoying it. Definitely a top 10 park for me. Just because of the theming. It's so nice, so clean, so well maintained.
They also have a Skyliner.
They've got Skyliner and they've got good food. So, what are we gonna do now, Tess?
We booked our last reservations at like 6:30 p.m. tonight for T-Express, and the ride closes at 7:30, so it's gonna be one of the last rides, and I guess we could just walk around and explore until then. We've done all the coasters, except for like that disco whatever.
Disco coaster, not a credit. So yeah, we'll walk around, but hopefully the next time we talk to you, we'll be riding our, or getting our fourth ride on T-Express, or getting pizza. Which one will come first?
Pizza.
It's a little dark now. Tess, are we about to get a night ride on T-Express?
I think we're getting one of the last rides of the night.
I don't know if it's going to be exactly LOROTN, but it's going to be pretty dang close. And that gets me hype as all heck. I'll let you know after we get off how truly dark it was, but it's time for ride 4 on T-Express. Wasn't a plan, but Tess and I officially just got last ride of the night on T-Express, and if I flip you around, as you can see, it's pretty dark outside, and we absolutely got a pretty dark night ride. Tess, what did you think of your night ride on T-Express?
Oh, it was so good at night. It was like 10 times better, and it was warm, as warm as it could be, and it was faster, so that was awesome.
Yeah, it was warmed up, it was fast. We were waiting for the back, and then they were like, last train, and we were like, well, I guess we're on last ride of the night, and so unfortunately we weren't back in the back, but that drop, especially at night, is just out of this world. It's got to be one of my favorite drops on a coaster ever. It's right up there with Sky Rush, like 1 and 2. It's absolutely incredible, and that basically describes our whole day here. You know, it's been absolutely incredible. The park is so nice, so well themed, so clean, good food, good drinks, really friendly staff, and some great rides too, and just a good variety of rides. You got coasters, you got animals, you got, you know, flats, you got like walkthrough attractions. So just really, really pleasant experience. Definitely enjoyed our time here. Tess,
I'm blown away by this park, and it's one of my top 5 favorite parks, like total, even like Disney World, you know, Universal, Islands of Adventure, and then Everland. Like, I love it. Yeah, I love it here.
So there you go. I hope you enjoyed coming around with us, and I hope you enjoyed this park as much as we did. If you like this video, be sure to like it and subscribe to the channel for more footage. And of course, stay tuned for more South Korea theme park footage coming soon to a Theme Park Blitz channel near you. It's this one. But basically, that's all we have for you. So thank you so much for watching.
Thanks for watching.
And have a good rest of your day, and I'll see you
next time
in our next video.
Bye.